Welcome back to Latest News with me, Yael Breuer. Our city is now in local election campaign mode and with a continuation of our campaign coverage of all the main political parties, Mark Walker spoke to the Labour candidate, Jackie O'Quinn, who is standing in the Goldsmid Ward.
I think that planning has become a serious issue in the ward, and it's what all three of us candidates are really working on very hard. And it is the fact that planning applications are going in for essentially water tower blocks. And they're OK, they're 8 storeys, 9 storeys, but they're still pretty big in an area where it's mostly terraced housing, yeah. Victorian terraced housing. And I know our argument has been you can actually get the same density with lower rise, with like townhouses of 3 to 4 storeys, yeah. And so on, because they have to be next to each other, whereas the tower blocks have to be a certain distance apart.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you get over awful problems, yeah, of overshadowing, yeah, and so on. So we just fought a major battle on that and lost. I went to planning, yeah, and objected to it. And then I've been talking to the people who are doing the development where the Hyde building is,
yeah,
which is Lions Close again, and that's IMEX, who are Amex. They do all the sort of, you know, events around the world.
Yeah.
And actually, they're a great company and you want to support them. And I do support them. I just wish they weren't building 50 flats on top of the offices they're going to have. But we have had much more positive dialogue than perhaps, you know, I managed, yeah, to have with Crest. So there have been lots of public meetings and so on. And now, of course, we found out there's a proposed hotel being built on the corner of Palmyra Avenue and, yeah, Cromwell Road that wants to have 80 rooms and build 80 flats. And it wants to have 7 storeys and it's going to go right next to the Belmead care home. And, of course, they're really in a state about it.
Yeah.
And I think this company that's doing it, I'm pretty sure that they heard that the cricket ground, which I've also been to visit, that they were going to try and hold events all year round,
yeah,
and be more active. So I think they thought, oh, there's an opportunity to have a hotel. And but I'm not quite sure. It's this idea that the hotel will have underground parking, but the 80 flats won't have any parking at all. So it's sort of a mad world, actually, Mark. And people are so upset about it. And, you know, I think what it's done for me is with planning is realise, like in a lot of other areas I've realised, that residents need to have more of a voice, and we're trying to set up, or we are in the process of setting up, is we've called it Hove Gold, and it will be a sort of, you know, a forum like there is for the Hove Station neighbourhood. And
yeah,
so it's a neighbourhood forum because we seriously need to have a lot more say about what happens in our part of the ward. So we will go right up to where the Hove neighbourhood plan is,
yeah,
and then up to Seven Dials, because it's become a very desirable postcode. And so developers are really moving in on it. And we're all terrified we're going to end up with this, I don't know, if you look at Lions Close and the future, probably development of Wick, Spitfire House and so on, you're going to end up with this site that is all tower blocks. And
yeah,
it's so inappropriate.